What I confess I did not expect, and so I'm happy to take responsibility for being naive here, is that Republicans who had previously supported comprehensive immigration reform, my opponent in 2008, who had been a champion of it, and who attended these meetings, suddenly would walk away. That's what I did not anticipate. And as you know, Jorge, even though we controlled the House of Representatives, even though we had a majority in the Senate, the way the Senate operates was if you couldn't get 60 votes, you couldn't get something moving. So we initiated the meetings, had a series of meetings. And what we could not get was a single Republican, including the 20 who had previously voted for comprehensive immigration reform, to step up and say, we will work with you to make this happen. Not only was it fairly recently that we had some Republican support, but even now you have voices like the former governor of Florida, Jeb Bush, who has said that the Republican Party has taken an extreme view, a wrong approach when it comes to immigration reform. So my hope is that after the election, when the number one goal is no longer beating me, but hopefully the number one goal is solving the country's problems, if they have seen that people who care about this issue have turned out in strong numbers, that they will rethink it, if not because it's the right thing to do, at least because it's in their political interest to do so.
What would you tell Hispanics voters right now if they actually are very interested in this important issue and all the dreamers that want to know if you become president, are you going to deport them or not?
Well, we're not.
Yes or no?
We're not going to round up people around the country and deport them. That's not. I said during my primary campaign, time and again, we're not going to round up 12 million people. That includes the kids and the parents and have everyone deported. Our system isn't to deport people. We need to provide a long-term solution. And I've described the fact that I would be in support of a program that said that people who served in our military could be permanent residents of the United States. Marco Rubio was working on legislation, which he called, I believe, the Dream and Achieve Act. It had a number of features that said kids that get higher education could become permanent residents of the United States. This is something that's going to have to be worked out by Republicans and Democrats together. I will lead a program that gets us to a permanent solution as opposed to what was done by the president, which with a few months before the election, he puts in place something which is temporary, which does not solve this issue. I will solve it on a permanent basis, consistent with those principles.
Did what Mitt Romney said last night resonate with Latinos?
Well, you know, the immigration issue, when you look at Latino voters across the country, immigration ranks up there more so than perhaps the rest of the population in the country. So people around here paying close attention. I'm not sure if Romney did a lot to sway a lot of people with his appearance yesterday. A lot of the people that we've spoken to have already kind of made up their minds either for Obama or for Mitt Romney. So but across the board, though, Brooke, what we keep hearing is it's education, it's immigration, it's the economy is the top three issues that they care most about, and it's Florida's a very interesting place across the country. Mm-hmm. President Obama enjoying a large lead in those polls among Latino voters across the country by some 40 points. In the state of Florida, it's actually a little bit closer from some of the recent polling that I've seen, and a lot of that has to do with just the differences in Latinos here in the state of Florida. Down south in Miami, you have a large Cuban population tend to vote Republican. Here in the Orlando area, for example, you have a large Puerto Rican population. They've tended to vote Democratic.
Fairness, I guess that's the biggest thing. I was like, I'm a middle class. I was like, my mom was a single mother. I was like, that she worked very hard to try to get what we have. I am originally from Puerto Rico. I was like, I came over here and I got a lot of opportunities. So I want to make sure that there is fairness. I was like, for you know everybody just like me.
Everyone can say change. Everyone says you know we need a new face and everything, but you know you have to be specific because Obama won the last election on being vague with change, but he did towards the end start specifying exactly what his Obamacare, you know, welfare reform, and he went through and he actually, whether he followed through with it or not, that's a whole nother issue, but he did, you know, start honing in on some of those issues. So Romney needs to step it up.